And we're back,
everyone.
We're here. We're not back.
It's been a while. That's what I mean. It's been a while
since we've done a show.
Because of various reasons. It's been 3 weeks because we couldn't be bothered to do one. I was in Macedonia.
Yes. How was that?
Weird.
Any highlights? What would you recommend to the tourists?
The highlight was coming back to the legendary 100 Club.
It is.
For another Dork's night out.
Yes, we are here once again.
Forgot. Remember the name of where we were. Forgot the name of the magazine for a second. Doing well.
Yes, Dork's night out. We're back. Headlined by the one and only Nell Mescal with Lexie Carroll and Scout.
And all of them are going to talk to us.
All of them are going to talk to us on this show very soon for a little bit of housekeeping, because obviously this will come out before The Great Escape. So, keep an eye out there.
Yeah, we'll be there.
We'll be there.
Keep an eye out on all the stages badged with that name.
Also,
that's where we'll be.
We'll be back at the 100 Club at the end of the month on Friday, the 24th of May, with secret special guest headliners, Perfume.
It's Jamie on Kazoo.
We can't tell you who it is. Sorry.
It's U2.
Might be. So any U2 fans listening, if you want to buy a ticket, I wouldn't, because it's not going to be them. It's going to be
sold five tickets at least.
Multiple Dork cover stars headlining. Buy a ticket if I was you. We're going to be announcing them with some special guests very soon. So put it in the diary.
I think as of now, it's 1/6 sold out.
Yeah.
And we haven't even announced anyone.
We haven't even announced anyone yet. Yeah, more than that. We haven't even announced anyone. So, like, don't be a fool and be like, oh, I didn't go to that. Buy a ticket. Get in there. That's what you want. Also, we'll be at Dr. Dot at the end of the month as well. Make sure you go to that as well.
Oh, I didn't even know we were going to be there.
Well, there we go. Live at Leeds in the Park. We're also there as well.
I knew we'd be there.
Okay, that's good. Well, great. Glad we're doing that. So, yes, tune in. We're going to be chatting to everyone here on the bill. Starting with the one and only Scout. What song, Jake, shall we play at this point?
I don't know.
Do you know who we could ask about this? It's people who are literally sitting in the same room as us, and it's Ruby and Matt from the 100 Club. How are we doing, guys?
Woo!
Yeah, baby!
Finally making their debut on the podcast after doing many of these shows at the 100 Club. How are we doing?
Oh, so good. So excited for tonight, man. I can't wait. Let's go.
This is him before every show.
Yeah.
I've never seen a man so overcome.
Jolly. We're a really jolly team, you know.
Yeah. This is it.
It's true.
It's going to be so epic. Can't wait to mosh. Let's go.
Let's go, indeed. Let's go.
He locked eyes with me quite aggressively or sexually there. I'm not sure which.
Both.
Well, what song should we play?
Yeah, any song.
Chop Suey.
By System of a Down. And this is Chop Suey by System of a Down.
Wake up! Grab rice and put a little makeup! Have the sense to fade away the shake-up! Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? Here you go, create another table! You wanted to! Grab a rice and put a little makeup! You wanted to! Have the sense to fade away the shake-up! You wanted to! Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? You wanted to! Why don't think you trust in my self-righteous suicide? Angels deserve to die! Wake up!
Here we are at the 100 Club, as you will have heard from the intro that we would have just done. But we are still at the 100 Club.
We are.
Because that's the show. And we're joined by the wonderful Scout. Scout, how are we doing?
Doing very well today.
Yeah.
Just waiting to sound check. I don't know. Can I say it?
Oh, you can spill the secrets. Yeah. You can spill them all.
Yeah,
I think people will be relieved to know that we let bands sound check.
Yeah, we do. I promise.
We still haven't played the show. Yeah, we're a pre-show.
Yes.
Yeah, we're sat in a little lovely office space.
Oh, it's a wonderful
next
office space.
to the venue. It's great. Yeah, very excited.
There's a lot going on. A lot of set times for shows that aren't this one. So here's hoping we have set times at some point.
Fingers crossed.
Folders.
Yeah, lovely folders here.
Just
I think most
scene,
of it's for show, to be honest. I'm just not sure what you'd need 10 folders for in a venue.
I think you'll find that Ruby and Matt at the 100 Club are actually just incredible people.
I've never put a show on in my life. I don't know what's going on.
Brilliant. How does it... I guess how are things, I guess, in general, really? Like, but like this is like... It's like a second show of like a batch of shows you're kind of like doing over the coming, like, I guess, like month, couple of months or so. Like, how... Yeah, I guess how are things in general?
They're good.
Yeah.
Actually, pretty busy. We've got this show now tonight, and then we've got another two lined up, which is kind of beyond my, you know, wildest dreams. Because I think I put out the EP on the 1st of March, and I was kind of like, okay, just going to start putting out music into the world. Mm. And then, yeah, started getting all these like Instagram DMs about like, are you... Can you know? Do you want to play a show? And I was like, "Oh, go on, why not?" But we were still kind of starting out with the live side of things. Mm. So yeah, very exciting, very fun,
nice.
And yeah, in the studio as well right now, recording the second EP.
So nice,
kind of juggling right now. I'm in my hustle era. Juggling, getting the live side of things started. Planning for EP3 and also finishing up EP2. So yeah, just busy.
That is a lot of juggling.
Yeah.
It must be nice to having the two, like the separate, you know, it's two very different parts of being a musician, right?
Yeah, which is fun. I'm still kind of getting my head around the go. I think from a vocal perspective, I realized in the studio, for example, I've been singing live for so, like I've been in live mode vocally. And yeah, that's just been like, when you go in and you record and it's a completely different vibe. That took me a little bit first. I was like, okay, shit, I can actually like, don't have to like push as hard to be heard. But yeah, it's been good. You know, just I'm still learning.
Yeah. And you can feel that kind of like as you kind of like go along as well.
Yeah, totally. We're hustling, we're juggling, we're doing everything right now, which is fun.
We are doing everything all at once.
Yes, exactly.
It must be great as well, kind of like, to put out music into the world and kind of see that reaction and then kind of give it a new life live as well. Like, have you definitely found like even the songs kind of, don't want to say like changing, but like you can feel like this different energy maybe when you're taking that to the stage?
Yeah, 100%. I think it's been really good. I've just done like the first few shows have been like real eye-opening in that sense that we're figuring out what works, what doesn't. I love like my band members are so good. I can't take credit for it, but yeah, it has been a lot of like kind of trial and error. Also, this is the first time for me doing it with a bit more of a technical setup. Like, I've got in-ear monitors and stuff like that,
which
I'm sure to, like, the average, you know, artist, maybe nowadays people, you know, use them a lot, but I've never used them before. Always just used floor monitors. So there's, like, been a lot of stuff kind of getting used to. But it's great. It's really good. Like, it's good from a perspective of actually, like, hearing yourself on stage and all that, which I'm sure is really boring to
I can hear myself now, this is good.
Just like complaining about not hearing themselves.
So this is what like hearing myself on stage is like. Like, this is good.
It's been a revelation.
Exactly. I guess that as well, like, that might like I guess feed in some ways maybe to like the music that you're making. Like, do you kind of like see that as well kind of like begin to kind of play out? Like, say you're already like say EP2, but then also looking at the next EP after that. Like, can you kind of like feel that as well?
I would love for things to get even more kind of interwoven. We're going to start putting songs into the set now from EP2 and hopefully even EP3, to just kind of start thinking ahead and also just starting to think about like doing even like a headline show, which something that again I didn't expect that I would be thinking about to this stage already. But like just making that more than just a set. I really want it to feel like a show. So we got some work to do over the summer, but definitely want to incorporate some of the visuals and stuff from EP2 that we're kind of just building on now.
Yeah, I was about to say, does it come in like almost like this whole like world of things for you? That's quite important.
I mean, obviously we're, you know, independent artists.
You're not going to be flying in on wires or anything.
yet.
Full on LED screen.
Yeah.
I wish. We're doing the best we can. But I love when you can build on the storyline and you can kind of bring in elements from other aspects. So the live show feels really tight wherever you are in the world now with your project or with Scout.
It's great.
Sounds exciting.
I'm excited.
And just kind of like bouncing off like people reacting to your music as well must be amazing. Both like, I guess like
it's game changer having people's putting out music where some people, even if it's not that many, but even just some people have heard the first EP and they're excited. But,
Really
cool. So, yeah.
Just looking out, it's like, oh, sweet. This is it. This is it. It's happening.
Yeah, but it's, actually, it's pretty mental about it.
Yeah, I mean, we always, like, when you talk to artists, you always, like, the moment that people remember is when they do a show and they look out and they're like, I don't think I know any of these people. You know? That's kind of the tipping point, isn't it? When you're like, oh, these are fans of mine. Yeah. These aren't just, like, everyone I've managed to get along because, like, you know, they're my friends or, like, friends of friends or whatever.
We're obviously planning my first headline show right now, and I'm so nervous. It's going to be, like, no one... But I'm trying to, like, just remind myself that, you know, by that point we'll hopefully be there. And it's not a massive room, so we should.
The O2?
Yeah, actually, I had to take it. It's between Wembley and the O2, and O2 just seemed like a better fit.
Of course. The restaurants on offer. Yes. You know, you've got to dive in. You've got to, you know, make an experience for everyone. Like, that's the wonderful vibe. Yeah. Nice. And I guess, like you say, like that kind of building of like a fan base who are kind of, you know, following you, wanting to know more and kind of like seeing that and connecting with the songs as well. Because I guess these songs are coming from quite a personal place. Mm-hmm. It's like to see that, I don't know, that kind of reaction that comes from people connecting with it. It must also be quite surreal. Really.
Absolutely. And it's interesting to see what connects with different people. Everybody so far that I meet have a different song that they're connecting to.
Yeah.
Whereas I think walking into it, I had this idea of certain songs a bit more of a pull than others, perhaps. But it's really kind of spectrum is quite wide in terms of what people seem to name their favorite song on the EP or whatever they connect to, which is, you know, cool.
It's cool. Well, we're very excited for the set. Later. It's going to be really great. Looking forward to everything that comes.
Thanks for having me.
But of course, because we are this show and because we are at the 100 Club, it's time for maybe the most important part of the chat, and that is the game.
The bit you said you were most excited
about. I'm actually very excited.
Get there.
Yeah, I mean, the EPs are fine and the headline show will be great, but what I'm really excited for is playing a game of 1 or 100.
1 or 100. Yeah, and Jake, what is 1 or 100?
We're at the 100 Club.
Yes, we are.
So we're going to ask you whether you would rather fight 100 of one thing or 1 of another thing. We've recorded this out of order, so we have already spoke to Nell Mescal, and I just want to flag, as it's something she brought up halfway through, you don't have to kill these things.
She was very much in a fight
to the death kind of mentality.
Just want to flag.
This is, you know, you just got to win the fight.
Just win or get past.
Well... I think you got to win. I think you got to win.
I think the people
in the audience have to know you've won the fight.
Yeah. It's got to be clear that you're the winner. But
like,
you do not...
We're talking like a physical fight.
Yeah. So, to start us off, would you rather fight 100 bees or 1 turkey?
I would say the turkey.
Yeah?
Yeah, for sure. Because I feel like I could... probably outrun it, whereas the bees,
hard to outrun a bee. We've all been at a picnic.
It's when you know, if they sting you, I just imagine there's hundreds of them, like that might take you down quicker than turkey. I also, for some reason, I'm an animal person, for some reason I connect more with
mammals.
Turkeys are like mammals.
Turkey would be
a bird. It can't fly though.
I was like, I'm an animal
really.
Person. Yeah. What is a turkey?
Yeah, the headline. Do you know what turkey is?
I've neither did you.
Okay, neither did I. I turned to Jake.
Let's edit that out. I would say turkey because I feel like I could. Probably win the turkey over somehow.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I like that. Yeah. Win the fight with kindness.
I like dogs. For some reason, they feel closer to me.
I can see it.
Yeah, turkeys are more human than bees, I guess, on the spectrum.
Well, yeah, that's...
Maybe.
Yeah.
I've never tried to make friends with a bee.
You're maybe not
can't
an
argue,
animal person
argue
either,
the
Jake.
Feeling.
Yeah, I'm getting that.
Yeah.
100 estate agents or 1 grizzly bear?
Well, I'm renting in London.
So you want to kick the shit out as an estate agent?
Is that what you're trying to say?
I'll take the bear.
You're taking the bear?
I think so. Because the bear, you know how on TikTok right now, it's all about whether you want to Would you rather meet a man or a bear?
Yes.
And I would probably say the bear. So, I'm going to go with the bear this time. It's like grizzly, though.
That's tactics, right?
Yeah, there's things
in American
and
TV.
And you've got one opponent here.
Make yourself big or small or something.
Yeah, exactly.
You'd have to find out which it was before, but I think it's one
and
of the
also,
two.
And also, we haven't, you know, how big is the space? That kind of stuff. Like, could I potentially... How aggressive is it?
Thinking.
Is it well fed?
Has it had a meal? Is it well fed? That's actually a good point.
Has it eaten 100 estate agents recently?
Well, estate agents, they would just, you know, I'm already... I don't know. I feel like I'm already...
that's just one of them.
Add another 99.
Even if you won, you'd somehow end up on a 5-year lease on a flat you don't want.
Exactly. Don't need another.
Yes. Bear strong. Yes.
Yeah, bear.
Yes. Jake.
100 cats or 1 Ford Focus?
Ooh.
Cats.
Strong in.
No. Oh, I don't want to fight the cat. Sorry. So.
It'd be the Ford Focus car.
You'd have to fight the car in whatever form that may take.
What is it? Driving? Is it?
Ooh, good point.
I don't think so. I think it's just there.
Okay. Well, I 100% just go with a car. I'm not going to fight an animal.
You just can't breathe. You can't breathe.
You don't have to be consistent.
Okay,
this is fine.
Well,
you know, we're working through this.
Yeah, there's no rhyme or reason. I'm just going to say.
Moving away from animals, I think we've probably got time for one more.
Yeah. Okay.
Because you do have to sound check. And we do want to make sure you can sound check. 100 SpongeBob SquarePants or 1 Buzz Lightyear. Neither are animals. So I think.
Well, a sponge is an animal.
What are you talking about? Sponge is an animal.
Sponge is an animal.
Sponge is not an animal.
We don't have time for this. I'll bring this. I'll take this up with you later.
I think I'm going to go with sponge.
Why are you thinking?
And I don't know why. Something about the squishiness.
Your gut is saying
easier squishy. On the fists.
Mm.
Easier on the fists.
Yeah, there's something about the whole SpongeBob's. I don't know. Yeah, I would say sponge.
Plus, we know he's tiny because he hangs out with a squirrel and he's smaller than the squirrel.
Right. Yes, yes.
And it's just the squishiness of it.
You think you can just
squishiness. We'll keep going back to the squishiness. It would be quite therapeutic in a way.
Yeah, right.
It's like a stress ball, basically.
Yes.
Great. With the idea
there
of...
what a great way to end.
Birds with one stone.
With the idea of a stress ball in mind. Scout, we are looking forward to the set.
Thank you.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah,
which song would you like us to play?
The last time.
Last time. Perfect. So that's what I've got written down as well. So that's a great shout.
Wow. Synergy.
This is
Synergy.
Last time. Bye, Scout.
Thank you so much.
Do you still hate your job? I don't know why I haven't tried. Sometimes when it's late at night, I feel lonely and tired. Looking around the side, trying to figure it out.
Here we are once again. It's Dork's Night Out. We are here. And we're joined right now by the one and only Lexie Carroll. Lexie,
hello.
How are we doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you doing?
Do you know what? I think we're doing all right.
Yeah, I'm pretty
good. We're doing all right. We're doing good. Doing good. This is obviously before show, as we mentioned before. So I think we're getting excited now.
Yes,
very excited. We're in the zone. It's all building up. How are things with you in general? Like, how's everything?
How's the world?
Life is good.
This is the only question we have. So,
I'll just roll for 20 minutes on this. I just got back from tour. I went on a tour with Bears and Trees. It was my first time going on a tour bus, which is really fun. But I came home and had the worst cold of my life. And now we've just been talking about the fact that I'm like on the up, but there's some remnants still there. So
it's like tour fatigue sort of thing.
Yeah, I feel like it's just one of those things where you're fine and then you get back and then all of a sudden your immune system's like, that was not good for you.
As soon as it knows you're in the clear to like relax, it's like, this is what we've been storing up for you.
Exactly. It's like, this is your payment
for all
eating
the fun.
Like shit and sleeping not at all.
Yeah, for all the fun that you've had.
Yes.
This is the effect of it.
Yes.
But an amazing tour.
It was really fun.
Nice.
It was just such a cool experience. Lovely people. couldn't ask for.
Yeah,
fun.
Is it nice to, like you say, to go out and play to these like crowds? Like, obviously, you're playing to crowds who maybe not necessarily know of your music before. Obviously, are there for the other band. Like, how is that experience? Is it like, like, how do you find it? Is it quite like freeing in a way? Because you're like, you know, I'm kind of just like introducing myself. Really.
It is the best. It's all the fun and none of the pressure of being the one who everyone's paying to see. Yeah, it's great. And like, people like are so nice to me afterwards. I'll always like stick around and people are like, oh, I'd never heard of you before, but you're really good. And it's just a very nice experience.
Meeting you're like, this is good.
Yeah,
this
it's good. Nice.
Especially when you are like, as you say, like, people aren't initially there to see you. So it's not like a foregone conclusion that you're going to get that. So it must be nice night after night to be like, I must be doing something right here.
Yeah, exactly. And especially like on the tour, it was crazy because a lot of people, Bears and Trees fans are like so dedicated to them. So they go to like multiple shows and then people like knew the words to some of my songs because they've been to like see the show so many times. It was just crazy by the end, like hearing people sing songs that aren't out and stuff. It was just like so cool.
You're there looking like, hold on a minute, how do you know these
songs? How do you know this?
Hang on a minute.
A little bit too close now.
Like, let me check on this because this is concerning.
A little bit. So nice.
Did you pick up any tour tips basically as you were going along? Like, judging
by the illness, I take it not.
Maybe not. I think I need to
more a list of what not to do.
I think like baby wipes became my best friend. Just like very sporadic showering was done. It was So yeah, just like learning how to. Oh yeah, just like getting ready in a public toilet was like got pro at that. Like brushing my teeth and I brushed my teeth in a Wetherspoons toilet at like 12 p.m.
They've definitely seen worse.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
If I went into a Wetherspoon's toilet and someone's brushing their teeth, I'd be like, someone here's hygienic.
Yeah,
that's good to know.
Yeah. Because like people kept coming in and I was just like, you know what? They don't care. They're just here to eat their breakfast, their full English breakfast.
That's the time of day as well where you're just sort of like, look, I'm not judging you. You don't judge me.
Yeah.
We're both in the Wetherspoons at an unseasonable hour.
It's
we're just going to move on. We're going to move on. This is a practicality.
Exactly. But yeah, that was quite a fun experience. And then we went to a in Leeds there was this like really really fancy shopping center that I would just go back and forth from to get ready in the bathroom of because it was so nice. It was like way nicer than the dressing room, so I just like do my makeup and then just go back. It was really nice. Really,
I love that you
really
found something like that. I think for the pre-show thing, find like a fancy
like some sort of like if there's like a perfume shop
and just run in, use their loo.
Exactly.
I'm in.
That'll be a nice loo.
A perfume shop.
Yeah, that will have a nice loo, right?
Yeah,
surely. I feel like all the smells mix together and get quite headachey. You know what? Have a good loo. Lush. I bet Lush would have a good
loo. Good shout. Yeah. These are tips for the next tour.
If you want to
take them and look for Lush
for
in any city you go to.
Yeah, I will.
Obviously, new music out as well. Launching.
For anyone listening at home, people are still sound checking. You're not just getting bleed from somewhere else.
Yeah. It's not like purposeful background music.
He's saying, why don't you replace the office of the 100 Club with a purpose-built podcasting studio for the one time every 2 months we're here? But they won't do it.
No.
Surprising. New music out. How does that kind of feel to be, I guess, kind of like back with almost like, I guess, like a new chapter? Like, does it feel like that for you? Or like, how does that feel?
Yeah, definitely. Like, I've been putting out a couple of singles, but it's all leading up to the EP. It's just really fun. Like, I love putting out music. It always feels like weird because you make the songs ages ago and then you like wait ages and then you sort of like forget about, well, not forget about them, but like, you're not really thinking about them that much. And then all of a sudden you're putting it out and it's just like, wow, that song.
Oh yeah, that one.
So it's really fun.
Nice.
And it's fun to like try and like, obviously doing like promo and stuff can be awkward and intimidating, but I try and like, I'm trying at the moment to just like have as much fun with it as possible because like,
I'm so terribly sorry that you've ended up with us.
I am deeply, deeply sorry. You've ruined it all.
We never get to do stuff like this. I'm more talking trying to do TikToks in my bedroom. Like
this is a really long TikTok.
Oh, great.
There's going to be so many jump cuts.
Yeah. Just zooms. Thank God there's no cameras.
The zooms and the zooms everywhere. Nice. Yeah. So, getting into the cycle of that again as well, especially with obviously new EP, coming out as well.
Yes.
Like, yeah, I guess like just getting that out there must feel like, I don't know, like, does it feel great to kind of like release that into the world and kind of see people's reaction? Because it feels like people are really reacting to kind of like everything that you're doing as
well.
Yeah,
it's so cool. Love it so much.
Yeah. It's like that kind of connection that kind of hits, isn't it? It's
yeah,
amazing.
Definitely.
It must be nice for you as well, I guess, to reconnect with it. Like you were saying, you write it and then months later it comes out and you're like, oh yeah. So it must be quite cool to be like, now it's out, you kind of you know, getting a relationship with those songs again in a way that maybe you didn't.
Definitely. Mm. And I feel like they like change. Like they're one thing when you write them, and then when you release them, like you see them in a completely different way, which is really cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're looking forward to that coming out. We're also looking forward to the set we are on tonight. It's going to be great. Looking forward to it. Sounded great in soundcheck.
Aw, thank you.
Because, of course, we're a highbrow podcast here, it's time to play a game.
Yay!
And Jake, what game?
No, you
what
can explain it this time.
Okay, I'll explain it.
This is the middle one.
Yes. So this is, because we're at 100 Club, we're going to play a game of 1 or 100. It's a classic game. What we're going to do is we're going to name, do you reckon you could fight or like take on 100 of one thing or one of the other? We're going to give you two choices.
Okay.
So whichever one you feel, okay, I think I can work this out. I can take this.
All right.
This will be the shout. So if we start with 100 bees or one turkey.
One turkey, for sure. I've got that in the bag.
I love that.
Everyone's picked the turkey. I'd definitely pick the bees.
No, you wouldn't, though.
Turkeys freak me out.
There's no way
They're
you
angry.
Can beat a bee, because if you whack it, it will just sting you.
Yeah, but then it dies.
But it's 100 of them.
No, yeah, you're getting 100 stings.
I reckon I can take 100 bee poisons.
I don't think you could.
No. I trust my immune system more than I trust my physical prowess.
you're like, I'm going to take the turkey.
I'm going to take the turkey.
That's fine. I mean, you do you. I respectfully think if this actually happens, you're all going to be like, I wish I'd gone with the bees like Jake did.
No.
As I'm there getting stung.
Yeah. I was about to say, as you come out like looking like a real like puffer man. Just like,
yeah. You're really going to regret that.
You definitely will. Easy. One turkey.
One turkey. Any day.
100%.
All right.
Send it in now.
And here it
and
is,
you'll never
the turkey.
Leave.
We thought it was a game. Jake, another one.
100 estate agents or one grizzly bear?
Oh, one grizzly bear. Well, I don't know. I just think 100 of anything is kind of stressing me out a bit. I feel like one is a bit more manageable. Estate agents.
Yeah.
A lot of them.
No, because they're probably quite easy to fight. Like, I wouldn't want 100 estate agents coming and, like, telling me off or something.
Yeah.
But if 100 estate agents to physically fight, go on.
Bring it on.
I feel like you could probably do, like, there'd be a lot of collateral damage from, they'd be hitting each other by mistake.
Yes, exactly.
You can duck and weave.
That's quite good. They'll be trying to sell you a house in the middle of it as well.
They're basically the only profession that still wear ties, so you can just hoik them out.
Smart, Santa.
Grizzly bears don't
no
wear ties.
They don't,
no
wear
ties.
Ties.
Don't wear a tie.
Come on, grizzly bears. Wear your ties.
Yeah, sort out your fashion.
Sort it out, for God's sake.
If only you could improve your fashion, grizzly bears.
Yeah.
A strong 100 estate agents. Okay, this is good. How about 100 balloons or one giant flag?
Ooh. I'm just confused how they're attacking me.
So the balloons are just kind of coming at you. They're constantly
batting them away.
Yeah, you're batting them away through the fog of balloons, basically.
Yeah.
The giant flag, obviously, just coming at you.
Oh, I reckon the balloons. I just feel like the flag you just get buried under, and that sounds claustrophobic.
I think that's the issue. The balloons would be annoying, but I'm not really sure there is a way that you could fail. Plus, how humiliating would it be if you lost a fight to a flag because you tangled yourself up in it?
Yeah, mortifying.
You got to think of your
honour, your prestige, your honour.
Yeah.
Come on.
Everyone be off that go. Just...
You know, announcing an XTP and they're like, is that the person who'd lost a fight to a flag?
Yeah. Flag lady.
Forever known as Flag Lady.
No. Yeah. And you could just get a little needle and just stab all the balloons.
Tactics. Yeah. This is good. Yeah.
Just you could just get one of the bees.
Oh.
You didn't find them, so they're still around.
Save up my bees and
send them to the balloons.
Yeah. Great.
Hustle them in.
That's the plan.
A good shout.
100 lakes or one ocean.
Oh. I feel like this is where you need to know things about the world. He's 100 lakes. Well, a lake can be any size, surely.
This is like an assorted range of lakes.
Mm.
And I'm fighting
it. You've got to conquer the lake somehow.
I'm getting...
You drink it, you freeze it.
I feel like there are some holes in this game. Yeah, how am I with fighting a lake?
That's up to you. You're the one in the ring
or
with the lakes.
Or am I swimming it?
I guess you've got to win, right? You've got to survive this.
The fight is... Don't drown.
Yeah, I get it.
In the sea, there are sharks.
Yes.
Ooh, this is a good point.
In lakes, there are not. You've got like frogs and things.
Yeah, less.
I reckon lakes then. And also, if lakes, like, you could call. Yeah, there are some really small lakes. And
there are some really big lakes.
It's an assorted. Yeah, but the ocean's just the ocean.
That's true.
You're not wrong. 100 lakes for me, please.
Okay. That's really good.
I think
logic.
An educated choice.
Yes.
A logical,
a really good choice.
That's me.
We've got time for two
and
more.
Educated.
We've got time for two more for you. So what we're going to do? We're going to say, how about 100 cats or one Ford Focus car?
I don't know anything about cars. So I don't know what a Ford Focus is.
It's kind of like a, I guess, like a regular car.
Yeah, regular car. Yeah.
Regular
family car.
Yeah.
A regular car or what's the other one?
100 cats.
Do you know what they are?
No. Give me a little... No.
They're sort of like a regular car, but smaller and furrier and animals.
Yes. Oh.
This is the one. This is the stumped one.
This is... Me. I'm not sure I'd want to fight the cats.
Mm, this is fair, yeah.
I feel like there would be some, like, moral...
Yeah, you'd win, but at what cost?
Yeah. Mm.
Your humanity.
Yeah,
you'd feel bad.
Yeah, I'd feel really bad for a long time. So I'm going to fight the car.
Yeah. There's, like, a strategy with the car, isn't there, as well? You could probably, like, you know...
What's that?
What are you
cut
doing
the tyres.
Use the bees.
Jamie's sort of making a jabbing motion.
Like
he's sort of like pushing a broom.
Yeah.
Just stick a broom in the car.
Yeah, with a car.
Conquered.
You're thinking of a bike.
Yes. There we go.
That's the problem.
Yeah.
That's very fair. I think. Yeah. Okay. I think this is a shout. The car has to be the one.
Yes.
And one more.
Okay. 100 worms or one Diana Ross.
Oh.
Well, again, I can't fight Diana Ross.
Oh, but think how famous you'd be.
What?
Not in a good way.
I don't think
any publicity is good publicity.
I don't think you'd want to be known as that.
No. Yeah. No, I can't even remember what the other... Oh, worms. Yeah. Oh, worms are so small. This is a silly one. Worms, like, you probably fight 100 worms just in your regular day.
What are you doing in a day? Please clarify.
Stomping through fields just killing worms.
Yeah, the tour has been a bit of a mad one.
Yeah, that's... I've just quit that stuff and now I just sit in...
I just think for me... Right, you're in the pub and someone says, oh, at the weekend, do you want to go to the cinema? And you're like, oh, sorry, no, I've got a big fight. And they're like, who with? And you're like, Diana Ross. They're like, oh my God, that's mad. You got 100 worms. They're like, you're weird. Why are you fighting 100 worms? That's my thinking. I wouldn't rather fight Diana Ross. I'd rather the world knew. And I'd let her win. And then
you'd let Diana Ross
win.
That'd be the line when she beats the shit out of me. Yeah.
Yeah. when you get attacked, basically.
Yeah. Ah.
You go with the worms if that's what you feel.
Yeah, I could go up.
But my name will be in lights.
Go to the pub and say, what are you doing on the weekend? Well, I was meant to be fighting Diana Ross, but I took the high road and now I'm fighting a load of worms.
And refuse to elaborate.
Yeah, and just leave it there.
And they'd be like, oh, of course.
Yeah.
You'd be like, anyway, see ya.
Yeah, bye.
With the image of you leaving the pub, say you're about to go fight some worms.
Yes.
Lexi, it's been a pleasure.
Oh,
thank you for spending time here.
Thank you
for playing the show. Looking forward to it. It's going to be amazing. We're going to play laundry detergent on the show now.
Yay.
Right now.
Cool.
Now.
Thank you.
Here we are, the 100 Club. We're here. It is a very hot day in the middle of London.
Yeah.
A scorching hot day.
Won't this be the third of the interviews?
Yes, it will be.
You've just introed it like it's the first.
But I'm letting people know.
Behind the curtain.
It's still warm.
We're here with headliner. Nell, how are you?
Hi, I've got a very warm. Yeah. I don't know if anyone's heard. It's very hot today.
They will have heard two or at least three times.
Definitely warm, I promise you. How are we doing?
I'm doing great.
How are things? You're in the midst of release week,
yeah.
I guess. How does it feel? I don't know. Yeah, just being in the midst of it. EP is out in the world. How does it all kind of feel?
Crazy. Like, it's such an exciting thing. I was so sick this week because of all the adrenaline that was like rushing through me. But yeah, it's been so lovely and the reaction has been so, so sweet. And yeah, I've kind of just been huddled with my friends the past few days, just like trying not to think too hard about it, but also trying to take it all in. So it's been really cool.
Have you kind of seen that change between like before the EP's coming out? You're like, okay, it's coming out. I mean, no, it's going to be 2 weeks away,
yeah.
1 week away,
yeah.
4 days away.
Well, because I was thinking about it even when we had finished recording and then we went on tour in December right after, like a week after we had finished the recording. And I was like, wow, it's out so soon. And then I was also like, no, it's out in so long. So that time has been so quick. It's so crazy. I'm so relieved and so glad it's out now. But yeah, it felt like a very long, well, also way too quick time.
Yeah. I like the premise. You're like, oh, I've got ages. Yeah. Oh no, here it is.
Yeah,
and it's
exactly.
out in the world. And these are the songs that I've made. And
yeah.
everyone's going to hear them now.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is my child. Please babysit for free.
Please look after it.
Yeah.
Has it been nice, I guess, yeah, just to see that reaction? Obviously, put out a few tracks before, but kind of just to see reaction to kind of the whole body of work, I guess, as well.
It's just been so nice. Like, the single thing is a weird concept because ideally you put out one or none and like whatever. But like, to be honest, I think at the stage I'm at, it's helpful. It's nice to have kind of more people jump in before it's out because then they can be like, oh, I was here for the first project rather than like come into it a few months late. So it has been nice to kind of slowly ease everyone into the EP and then to kind of bring Electric Picnic in July into the mix like on the actual day. But yeah, it's just been a very strange, very cool time. It's been so fulfilling creatively. So yeah, I've loved every second.
I guess it must be amazing as well. It's something you kind of like build up to. It's like, right, my first kind of, yeah, like, but yeah, body of work, I guess, is still the best way to describe it. Like, did you kind of have that clear idea from the outset of kind of like what you wanted to do with it? Or has it kind of very naturally fallen into place?
Someone asked me this question recently and I was like, I'm just so all over the place all the time that like I could have really planned out every step and done the Taylor Swift treatment of like, I'm going to give you a clue 10 years in advance and it's going to be so sick. But I
think she does have people to help her.
You're in it for the long game as well. You're like, look, the EP's coming in 10 years, guys.
Yeah, but like I couldn't. Like initially the EP looked so different and then we got into the studio and then even the week before we were in the studio, I was adamant that it was these other songs and then we're in the studio and I decided last minute to put Warm Body in there. Killing Time was written the week it was supposed to be recorded. It was very stressful for everyone on board and eventually I just had to stop the phone and I was like, I'm going to make the EP that I want to make and I hope that you still love me after. And then afterwards I was like, I'm really happy with it. So I think that's kind of what matters because it's the piece of work that's a part of me. And so it was very different to what I initially thought it was going to be, but so much better and so much brighter and so much more spacious than I originally thought it was ever going to kind of go. And so it was really nice. But like specifically, Warm Body was a huge song that was like changing the entire landscape of the whole EP because before that, and I give that up to my friend Sam who wrote on Warm Body and Electric Picnic because he had these guitar tones and these guitar sounds that I was like, I need those riddled throughout the whole thing.
Yeah.
And then I went to Duncan Mills, who's also a genius. And so it was that the collaboration part was so, it was just too valuable. It was crazy. So yeah, it's been a very cool experience.
It must be good to be vindicated as well when it's come out and be like, people like it.
You're playing out every scenario in your head, just
truly.
like
because Killing Time, a few people didn't love it on the team and I was going, guys, you just have to trust, like you have to trust me, I love it so much and maybe I won't like it in a few weeks and that is my cross to bear, so please. And then like
you'd have to pretend anyway then.
I know
you can't walk into that beating again.
I got a text of those people being like, we made a mistake, you killed it, and I was like, that's good, that feels so good. And But yeah, I think that's the cool thing about like your first project. You can take as many risks as you want, and it's never going to be what's like cements you into any genre. It's like, this is just your introduction, and you're just saying, hello, I'm here. I like this and I like this, and who knows what I'll like next.
This is what I can do.
Yeah.
This'll be great.
Yeah, so it's been cool.
It's not going too badly if it's a debut EP and I had to dodge around a queue of people.
There's a queue of people already outside.
An hour before doors, an hour before?
A bit more. They've been here a while.
My friend Molly was coming in and she said, yeah, there's girls just like sitting out. And I was like, that couldn't be for me. It's 4 p.m. I haven't even arrived. Like,
don't worry, Jamie's given them a couple of Dork magazines. So yeah, I'm sure they'll be
available online right now.
Amazing. Oh my God, online on this very hot day.
Exactly. What's better on a hot day? Yeah. Cool magazine.
It was either they were queuing for this or they're queuing for the offices upstairs.
Or Primark next door.
Or Primark next door.
I'd queue. Yeah.
You're like, you don't have to. They'll let you straight in.
You're like, is there a queue?
Like, you're one step away from closing the store for you.
This has ruined it. And I guess like you say now, this kind of almost, yeah, you're in release week. Everything's kind of like coming out. Like, are you already like looking ahead? And kind of obviously tonight is kind of like, a celebration of kind of, yeah, the EP and kind of everything, the journey to now. But like, have you already got that idea of like, exactly where you want to go next? I really like,
yeah, like there's new songs on the set list that we're playing that have never been heard before, and I kind of wanted to do that. I want to, and I've taken a few of the older songs off the set list, which I'm hoping people are okay with, but I do think
we'll let you know later tonight.
I do think like the past year has been so big for change for me, and so like every song I'm writing feels a bit different, and so this EP feeling still like it's a part of me is really exciting, and then getting to put two new songs on the set list and being kind of like, this is where we're going for the next one. And so yeah, I definitely have already kind of been planning the next project, whether it's an album or another EP. I kind of don't mind. I'm like, I'm very lucky I'm not being rushed into anything, and I'm going to America tomorrow to do some writing, and I'm like so excited because it feels like the right time to release something and then immediately go off and let other people live
run
with
away.
It. Yeah, well, because I've been living with it. Like, I've listened to it honestly so much.
You're
like,
done with it.
I do love it, and that's the exciting thing of like not having to stress out about it. I'm like, this just lives here now, and I love it so much, and I'm so confident in it, and it feels so like me. Because I used to release songs and be like, would my hero like the song? And then stress out. And like, that's what I would think about. And now I'm like, I don't care because I think they would like it because I love it. And
I have to ask, who is the hero in mind? Because I've got this image that immediately you're just like, yep, this person right here. Listen to my song. How's that going?
Well, it's just like all the, like, I think about like Ethel Kane and Lucy Dacus and all those people of like the people that I've gone to their shows and I've been obsessed with everything on release. And you always kind of are like, it's like that Chapel thing that's going viral now being like, I'm your favorite artist. And like, that's kind of the goal because you just want to like make music that people think, like, people are inspired by, because I make music because I'm inspired by other people's music. So it's nice to kind of feel sure in the project and then be able to move like on and kind of be like, and that gets to stay there and people get to listen to it. It's so exciting.
And that reaction as well from people being like, this is amazing, this means X to me, and I'm like, you must see that quite a bit, because you can see this kind of like community that's kind of forming. Really,
it's the loveliest thing ever, because that's how it's like, you write songs that you, it's the most selfish thing I can do, is that I can write exactly what I want to say and force people to listen to it. And I can say exactly my experience and then hope people can figure out their own experience that aligns with it. But I can say, like, there's a line, Kira said she saw you crying on the EP, and that's my cousin Kira. And it's like, if I heard a random name, I wouldn't connect to it as much. But like, because I wrote it, I'm like, wow, she's speaking some truth here. And like, that's really cool for me. So then when other people can relate to it, I'm like, yeah, because I wrote a song that I needed to hear. And the fact that you needed to hear also is like the most amazing. It is just community. It's like just being able to bring people together. And it's cool that I get to be a part of that.
Exactly. And I guess you're in almost like a different space of life now compared to when the EP was being written as well, and kind of everything like that.
Yeah,
so
for sure.
You've kind of got that capsule of time, really. Like, does it feel like you're like, right, that is a moment in my life that's
there
forever.
Yeah, well, that's
forever.
The thing, because people are always like, oh, will you like this in a year's time? And I used to be like stressed out about that. And I'm like, doesn't really matter if I like this whenever, because I think I will. But what matters is that I like it now, because this is just a marker of time. Like, because we'll have so many, like you could have, it's like Taylor Swift again, like all these eras, and they're all a marker of where she was and who she was at that given time. And that's the thing that's cool. Trying to like get 10 steps ahead of yourself and be like, well, if I think this is not cool in 10 years time, I failed. It's like, no, it means you've grown and you've changed and that's sick. So
also, hopefully there's gonna be a few more EPs by that point.
This is it.
Yeah, this is it. I'm done. It's been a really cool career.
Thanks, guys.
No, so I think it's like cool to, yeah, it just, it's a marker of time, and this is where I'm at now. So it'll be exciting to see where I'm at in a year's time and so on, so forth.
It's going to be great. Well, we're looking forward to the show later
on.
So
excited.
It's going to be very, very good. Very sold out. Very busy. Because we are at the... Well, not at the moment. No, it's relatively empty at the moment. But promise you, people are coming. That's it.
Sick.
Or they're in Primark. It's one of the two.
Yeah,
maybe. One of the two. You'll find them somewhere. Because we're at the 100 Club.
Yes.
And because, of course, this is Downward Boring, we're going to play a game.
Amazing.
Now. Jade, do you want to give us a little overview?
Yep. So, as I said to you before we were recording, we have done enough gigs at the 100 Club now that we're fast running out of puns and related things to do. But we managed to find another one. So this is going to be, this is called 1 or 100.
Okay.
We're going to give you two options of, you're getting into the boxing ring and you have to fight one of these two options. There's going to be 100 of one thing or one of another.
Okay.
So to start us off, would you rather fight 100 bees or one turkey?
One turkey? Because how are you fighting those bees? You're just getting stung and then playing dead until they run away.
You get stung 100 times, you've won. Because they die when they sting you, right?
But I don't want to get stung 100 times. A turkey?
Boof.
Like a little kick.
Weird talons on the back of their feet, man.
I'm doing one little kick straight up into those bees and then I've won it all. I've won the
whole
thing.
The bees are still there, they're just on your side. No,
they're just at the side, just like, well,
they're waiting for their turn.
Didn't pick us, so like, that's absolutely fine.
Left out again.
I just really love also this idea of like, you've been stung 100 times, so you win at that point. Yeah. I was like, I don't know if you'll be feeling great.
No, but you'd win.
No, I want to win and feel like feel happy.
Right.
And not kind of need to be hospitalized.
Yeah,
that's ideally.
Yeah.
A strong shout for the turkey. How about 100 estate agents or one grizzly bear?
Do you know what? I want to fight every estate agent that has ever existed. This doesn't need to be a game. Set it up. I will do it.
Send them to the
ring. They suck. It's like, I can't, like, them and landlords, I'm like, I'm ready.
Yeah.
I'm ready.
It's not even a case of if you think you will win, it's like, I just want to fight.
I just want to fight them.
And take down 15 estate agents.
Yeah. I'll bring a few.
Any estate agents listening, you know, you're a person in your own right and your job doesn't define you.
But also.
But if you see Nell run, that's kind of
Or just
the
don't
advice.
Disclose your job.
Don't be wearing the shiny suit.
Don't have the Foxton's jacket on at that point. So move away. So a strong 100 estate agents, necessity at that point.
Yeah.
100 cats or one Ford Focus?
What the fuck? 100 cats or one Ford Focus? Well, the only cat that I think of is my friend Lucy's cat, Rudy. And when I lived with Lucy, this cat was kind of like my child. And I kind of also hated this cat. So
I'm
like, if I had to fight 100 of these cats, like I wouldn't win. And it would just make me frustrated. I'd just be crying the whole time. I'd be like, oh, because you're so annoying. So maybe the Ford Focus, because I kind of have this, I just saw Fall Guy and I feel like I would just kind of run up on top of it and then be on top of it. And then what can the Ford Focus do?
Nothing.
Like,
it doesn't have arms.
What can that do? Whereas the cat can like kind of claw you. So I think as soon as I'm on top of that Ford Focus, it's one and done.
Yeah, okay. You just gotta get on top of it.
Yeah.
The stunt
100%
approach.
Success
rate. The Ryan Gosling.
You've seen Ryan Gosling do
it. I'm really throwing out these puns. I'm saying one and done, 100% success rate.
That's true.
It writes itself.
It just writes itself.
I've got it covered.
Yeah. That's a choice for the Ford Focus car in that battle there. And understand your show. 100 lakes or one ocean?
100 lakes or one ocean?
Mm.
Well, I'm thinking of a still lake.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know how I would fight this. As opposed to I used to kayak.
Oh,
right.
There, it would be very, very busy lake.
Like rapids.
Rapids, yeah. I'm not really about that. But also... In what they're trying to actively drown me?
I think that's the case. Yeah.
Well, then one ocean, because realistically, you wouldn't survive after the third lake tries to kill you. Do you know what I mean? Like you're out of breath.
I love the logic.
You're struggling. Whereas one ocean, that's like one lake.
Yeah.
Sorry, I think you guys need to rethink your.
Yeah. When does the lake become the ocean?
Well, because the
ocean,
lakes
are freshwater, right?
Yeah.
Right. So they're stiller.
So you can drink them. Is that what you're implying? Yeah, but then you're overhydrated, and I don't like to drink any water. Like I've had that all day. You guys can't see this, but
maybe you'd be really thirsty.
There is literally, I think there's
1.5 liters, and I've had one sip, and it's a whole day, and I have a gig today. So I don't think the lake water's for me. I think I would survive quicker if I didn't have to drink the water.
Right. Mm. Okay.
Ocean.
Okay. Okay. Strong ocean.
Okay. Yeah. I respectfully disagree.
And I did nearly drown once in the ocean.
Oh.
Well, why are you in the ocean then?
Because I survived it. I won.
Oh, you won. You won history. 1-0.
Yeah. Yeah. Truly.
It's fair. It's fair.
I've got history.
Yeah. Yeah, we go way back.
We go. Yeah, we got it covered.
Like a grudge.
Got it
covered. Like in Rocky when they bring back some characters from a previous film.
The ocean is back again.
100 balloons or 1 giant flag?
Well, what are the balloons realistically going to do? Whereas the flag will wrap around you.
Jamie wrote this one. Ask him.
And here's this is the thing.
I'm the lake guy, not the balloon guy.
I'm going to bring us back to the drowning one because when I nearly drowned in the sea, I was sailing, and this sounds made up, but I was sailing and the flag.
The flag came
on top of me. So I was on the water and that was wrapped around me and I genuinely passed out for like 15 seconds underwater. I did survive it.
You did.
But it shows the anger of the flag.
And maybe the flag wants another round and maybe the flag will win the next time. So I think maybe 100 balloons because realistically I'm just kind of going pins, throwing them up in the air.
Ooh,
and then
strategy.
All I have to do is like that a few times and then they're all gone.
I'm glad we can really bring up trauma.
Yeah, no, it's good to do that.
It's good to do that.
Have you listened to the EP?
Yeah, the song, A Flag Wrap Around Me. I didn't realize it was so literal. You wouldn't have put these in.
Yeah, no metaphors, no metaphors.
No metaphors at all, yeah.
Got time for probably 2 more.
Okay.
So we're going to go with 100 SpongeBob SquarePants or 1 Buzz Lightyear.
I think it would be really annoying to have 100 like SpongeBob's in the room, personally.
Just in the room at all.
I'm not sure he's killable. Isn't there
he's a sponge.
There's bits in the show where he gets like cut up and he's still fine.
But you could just like, well, actually, sorry, I was going to do a whole monologue there, but actually just take him out of the water. Just like lift him up and then he's
dead. That's true, dry.
So otherwise I was going to say, wait, what was the
Buzz Lightyear?
Or Buzz Lightyear. See, I just think it would be more interesting to watch that because he's going to put on a show. Whereas SpongeBob is just going to get all drunk and it's going to be kind of gross.
I'm glad that you're thinking of the spectacle at this point.
It's, yeah.
You know.
Well, because we're going to put on a show tonight.
We're going
to if he was here, I know he'd like to be involved in that. Like, I kind of think like Buzz would kind of go about it like wrestling. Kind of like, we know it's kind of a show. We know that's like a setup.
It's kind of hench.
But someone has to win.
Yeah.
Mm.
And it would be me. But I would just, for safety reasons, I would kill SpongeBob 100 times.
Okay. I would kill 100.
That's what I'm thinking.
I would eviscerate.
I would murder this sponge
so hard the show would stop existing.
I would murder this murder. Strong in.
No, that's clear.
Yeah.
Okay, last one. 100 worms or 1 Keith Richards?
Ooh. 100 worms or 1 Keith Richards? Can I get a photo of Keith Richards?
Whoa.
Do you have a photo of Keith Richards?
Oh, I thought you meant like as part of the fight.
If I win, can I get a photo with him?
Are we talking Keith Richards now?
Now, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I think the issue with Keith Richards is I don't know if you take that bandana off, if he'd just crumble into dust.
Well, that's the thing, because if we're going young Keith Richards.
Okay, so no, Keith Richards 2000.
It's only 100 worms. So.
It's only 100 worms, but how am I getting through? Because otherwise I just have to step on
them. There is a modern Keith Richards
right
there.
Oh, I don't want to kill him.
But I feel like if you took this bandana off, he would just unravel like a mummy.
Okay. I think I would...
That's why the hat's not fully off. He can't take it fully off.
I keep saying kill.
Yeah,
so I don't know how I would beat up worms without murdering them.
That's true. You might get disqualified for killing
worms. And also, we're trying to save the earth.
Yeah.
So maybe Keith has to go.
Maybe
Keith
has to go.
Maybe Keith don't come to the 100 club tonight.
No.
There
are photos of him around here, so he's been here.
That's true.
That's all we know.
Yeah, not tonight.
Don't come to 100 club tonight. You've heard that, Keith Richards. And he listens.
I love starting indie beef, you know.
Yeah.
Nell Mescal, Keith Richards.
This is it. This is the beginning.
As soon as he works out social media, he's coming for you.
He's
going
to be here. Yeah.
And he's going to work out social media
as well. The 200 club.
Now. it's been a pleasure. We're looking
forward
to the show.
Me.
It's going to
so
be amazing.
Excited.
Which song from your EP should we play right now on the show?
Oh my God. What's the vibe you're looking for?
Sort of a song by Nell Mescal as the vibe.
Ooh, that's going to be a tough one. Electric Picnic.
Yeah, do
it.
This is Electric Picnic by Nell Mescal.
Slay.
How could you write a song by me? I'm looking on the barrel and I'm missing my old bedroom. Why'd you show?
that was the week that was.
Yes, that was it. What a huge Dork's night out. We can confirm it was amazing. Thanks to everyone who came down. Thanks once again to the legendary 100 Club for hosting us.
And no thanks to Matt for making us play Chop Suey at the beginning of the show.
Again, we'll be back at the 100 Club at the end of the month for Perfume. Buy a ticket now.
Also, it's getting to summer, so if there's not a show every fortnight, that's because we're in a field somewhere recording another one. So
I'm tired.
Be patient.
Be grateful.
Be gracious.
Be all of those and more. Thanks for listening, everyone. We will catch you at The Great Escape.
Bye.